We all had that car we dreamed about as a kid. A lucky few of us were able to buy that car, and fewer still were able to hold on to it. Rick DeBruhl has this story of one Air Force veteran who, in the midst of battling a challenging disease, is seeing his childhood dream come back to life.
He first saw the car in an ad.
It's a 1976 Pontiac Trans Am, 455, four-speed. It's the 50th anniversary edition. So it has the gold honeycomb wheels. It has the gold embezzlements on the outside.
Joe Barthiol was just a kid back then, but he was instantly hooked. Years later, when he was stationed at Luke Air Force Base in Arizona, he saw one.
I went over and looked at it, and it was the car I wanted. It was the gold edition, 50th anniversary of Pontiac.
When the pilot who owned the car was transferred overseas, Joe bought it, and he kept it even as his family grew, until...
And I stopped driving it because I got orders to Korea. It had been breaking down, and finally the orders just did it. So I had my father-in-law take it out to their place in Tonopah, Arizona. And it's 40 acres of desert.
So it's
set out in the desert, pretty much in the same spot the entire time.
I think it was about 20 years the car sat.
And just as the car has faced troubles, so has Joe. He was recently diagnosed with colon cancer.
So it's just been trying to fight the battle and, you know, all along. And then eventually the chemo stopped working, you know, after a couple different tries of different chemos. And the cancer came back in multiple organs, including his brain.
Joe had long dreamed about restoring the Trans Am. Now his wife, Jackie, knew finishing the job was a race against the clock.
About a week before Thanksgiving, I got a call from this gentleman's wife telling me the story that he had cancer.
Tom's busy shop in Phoenix was backed up, but he knew he had to make room.
I felt like it was something that we could make happen for him, that we could do for him.
Yeah, but not without a lot of work.
Imagine the car with weeds growing up through the bottom of it, the interior falling in the seats, the hood rusted out, the bird on the hood now gone, the flaming Phoenix was no more, the scoop was deteriorated, the engine's full of water. It was a mess.
1 year later, the car is finished, and Joe is about to see his childhood dream come back to life.
Just to know that this is actually going to happen, it's amazing. Just unbelievably amazing.
It's a very gratifying feeling knowing that they're going to, in a few minutes, see this car and their dream come true.
So are you ready?
Yes, absolutely.
As psyched as you can possibly be. All right, family, we ready?
Yeah.
So excited.
Right.
Let's go look at this thing.
All right, honey.
I'm gonna let you lead the way.
Yep. Oh my.
Not surprising, it's the closed door.
Over here.
You guys ready to see it?
Door is opening.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah. They were just singing Eastbound and Down this morning.
Well, you know, you don't have to stand back here.
That is great.
So does it look like it did the day you bought it?
It looks 100% better than the day I bought it. This looks brand new.
Wow. Beautiful.
Oh.
Tom, can we pop the hood?
Oh.
The engine isn't greasy.
Well, why don't you go sit in it? Let's see what it looks. See how
yeah.
it sits. Put it on.
I think it's been a great distraction for him. You know, I think for him to be able to take his mind off of the cancer itself, and I think the car, you know, has done that.
Tom Blackwell says that while his shop did most of the work, he was helped by plenty of suppliers and craftsmen who wanted to make sure that Joe's dream came back to life. Up next, we hit the road for a drive to California's Cabrillo National Monument for a change of scenery and perspective. When Driven continues